Hey everybody, it's Alex Dixon with Studio 722. I'm coming at you with another Cubase tip. This go around we'll look at printing your tracks via routing in Cubase, pretty much using it as a summing thing. Now you can do this with multiple tracks, you can do it with single tracks, you can do it with your entire mix. The steps are pretty much the same. And today we're going to look at converting this VST instrument. We're going to look at this We're going to look at printing this VST instrument, this piano sound, onto this audio track. Pretty much the very first thing you want to do, you want to have a bus set up. Pretty much go to your VST connections, go to your outputs tab, set a stereo bus or mono bus, depending on which type you want. And then you're going to want to go set up the routing, go into your mixer, go over to the channel. After you create your audio track, you want to set the input of the audio track to track record one or whatever you named it, and the output of the VST instrument to that track, to that bus. And if you want to capture the effects, like the send effects, all you have to do is solo out the instrument you want that sent to that effect, and then you're going to want to route that effect bus over to the blank bus. And then all you do is you hit record. And if you want to hear it recording as it goes, you're going to want to have the monitor button selected. So now we go back and put everything on back to where it was. That way we can hear everything properly. And now we can mute. Now we can mute the VST instrument or disable it or whatever. I'm just going to solo the audio track that we just made, and here we go. You can hear the reverb was captured nicely with it, you know, into the stereo audio file. Personally, I'd recommend printing most of your instruments to stereo audio files, you know, like especially if you have an effect like reverb or something. But where this comes in handy is if you want to use the audio file for later in another project, you know, that way you don't have to re-record it. You know, you can use it as a sampled file, if you will. You know, that way you don't have to re-record the MIDI or anything like that. So yeah, this has been Alex Dixon of Studio 722 with another Cubase tip. Talk to you later. Deuces.